Well, so you could say it is done and dusted. We're talking the 23-24 national budget that has been read now, and what is left is how it is going to be implemented and how to be impacting you as an individual, but also as a business person. So I attended a recent conversation about the East African Community budget and how debt is going to affect the region in general. And one of the things that stood out was, why is it that people are only consulted, the public is talked to after the budget? The whole conversation should be before, so we understand the priorities of the people and then we align them in the budget. Well, it's only something that maybe we can hope will work. Plus, can URA attain the 29.7 trillion shillings target that has been set for them? And worryingly, is the biggest chunk of the budget will be going into debt repayment. Regardless, we move, regardless, we shall pay the taxes. And our only hope will be that the taxes are spent wisely for the common Ugandan to benefit. Welcome to the Business Show. My name is Simon. From wherever you're watching, we are glad you could make time. We have a lot lined up for you for the next minutes that we're here. So stay with us and let's run you through what's coming up on the show this week.
I began this business in lockdown 2021. We were stuck in lockdown. They chased me from my former job. I was among the people that didn't survive, actually. So I bought plants, house plants, from a friend of mine called Letitia. And the peace that the plants gave me was just different. Honestly, it was just different.
Once again, welcome to the show. Now, it's not the first time that we hear conversations around the supremacy of the dollar against any other currency. And even down here in Uganda, we've seen tenants downtown in these arcades say they cannot pay their rent or have their rent computed in dollars. Across the region, we've seen Tanzania directing its business community and citizens not to pay for foreign goods using dollars. This is all meant to help the local shilling gain. Now, this week on Views from the Top, we speak to Dennis Nwagaba, who is a senior lecturer at Makerere University Business School, or popularly known as MUBS, who talks to us about why countries are now shifting from dollar supremacy, weighs on why this is good for developing countries, and also on the challenges. This and more in Views from the Top.
My name is Dennis Nwagawa. I'm a senior lecturer in the Department of International Business and Trade at Makerere University Business School. I would like our viewers to know how we have come to this stage, even of talking about de-dollarization. It is important for us to understand that the dollar has dominated the global economies since the end of the Second World War. Our viewers need to know that at the end of the Second World War, USA emerged as the world superpower, and not only militarily, but also economically. And this gave USA an upper hand in influencing the economic affairs of the world. It is also important at this stage to mention that the Bretton Woods institutions that were created at the end of the Second World War were largely a sponsorship of the USA. And these specifically are the International Bank for Reconstruction, which is the World Bank, and then the IMF. These institutions have dominated global economics and they have influenced how countries trade with each other or conduct their economics. So the World Bank, which was the bank for the reconstruction of the economies after the Second World War, was largely financed by the US, and that gave the US an upper hand in dispersing its currency across the world. So countries that needed money to develop their economies after the Second World War depended so much on the use of the US dollar. And that has made the US dollar a dominant currency in the rest of the world. Now, the US dollar continues to dominate world economies. And you and I need to know that you are not a rich man until you have enough dollars on your account or in your pocket. It is important again to appreciate that world investments, world trade is usually denominated and dominated by US dollars. Investors transfer capital in form of US dollars, and importers and exporters would wish to earn or be paid through a US dollar. And that made the US dollar to dominate the world economy. And this has resulted into what we now call the dollar hegemony, in which the dollar controls almost all the other currencies of the world. My thinking or my reading of the statistics is that a move away from the dollar or the weakening of the dollar will give rise to the next biggest currency. And in this case, it is the euro. Because the euro is the second widely used currency in the world, but also it is the second reserve currency in the world. So if we are looking at the next currency to take over, if the US dollar does not survive, then it would be the euro. And again, you need for us to know that the euro and the dollar are somehow connected by their trade systems. Now, what would be then the next currency? If it is not the euro, if it is not the dollar, which one would be the next currency? It is now believed that the Chinese yuan could actually take over if those three currencies do not work out. But the question is there a possibility that all these two currencies, the US dollar and the euro, will fail for the Chinese yuan to take over? Now, African countries are talking about moving away from the dollar. But I would wish to caution African countries of this idea of moving away from the dollar. Now, since independence, our reserve currency has been the US dollar. That has an implication on how to move away. It's like a marriage. You don't just move away from the marriage. There's a history that connects us with the US dollar, and that history is very important. Remember that Uganda has received concessional loans from the multilateral lenders. And when I say the multilateral lenders, this is the World Bank and the IMF. These loans or these debts can only be financed in US dollars. So if we move away from the dollar, where shall we get the dollars to pay back our debts? Remember that some of these debts are long term. They are long term, 30 years, 50 years, and we have to finance them using dollars. So even as we think about moving away from the dollar, we must remember that we have obligations at multilateral level, and we need to finance these obligations. And the only currency we can finance these obligations is the dollar. Now, the other concern that I want African countries to pay attention to is the nature of financing that we are receiving from China. Because Africans largely are moving to China for financing. But there's a catch. One is that the dollar trades freely on the global market. But the yuan is a controlled currency by the Central Bank of China. And if that yuan is not allowed to float freely, then it will present a challenge to African countries, because somebody who lends you the money and then controls how you can access their currency to pay them can actually cripple you in the process. Because it means that China could make it difficult for African countries to access the yuan. And when that becomes difficult, then we will not be able to finance our loan obligations. And in the long run, we'll be highly indebted to China. And that is a point that African countries need to be concerned about. My thinking is that we need to know that there is a contestation of power in the world. And the challenges that the countries have had with the dollar could be the challenges that countries will have with any other currency that will be dominating. Because the question lies in, if you need the dollars, you must be able to generate the dollars. So we still have a supply side constraints. If we cannot export more, we will not earn the Chinese one, and we will not either earn the dollars. So either way, we will suffer, not because of the dollar, but because of the foreign currency that we are using, that we are not earning. And therefore, I don't think it will help anybody, any African country, to move away from the dollar to the Chinese one for the sake of changing a currency, a reserve currency. I think what is important is to us is whatever currency we move to, whether it is the dollar or the yuan, are we able to earn it? Because see, our trade terms with China, we are importing more from China and exporting less from China. It may actually become worse, that the demand for the Chinese yuan may be higher, that the Chinese yuan becomes more expensive than the dollar that we've been using. Because if we are not exporting any goods to China, then it means that we will not be able to earn the Chinese yuan, and we will not be able to use it, because it will be difficult for us to acquire it because we are not earning it. Now, note that the dollars are coming into Africa, in Uganda, in different ways. One, we export to the US in some way. Through AGOA, we export. But also, US donates some of part of development support that they give to African countries. Through NGOs, we earn these dollars. But ask yourself, how many other support is China giving to Africa that will bring in the yuan? And if we move away from the US dollar, which comes from other ways that we don't earn,
other than trade,
those increase our potential, our access to the dollars. But if the access to the yuan is going to be trade, and we are not trading with China, we will be, it is a zero sum. We'll not be earning anything. I think that regional integration is one way of reducing our dependency on any foreign currency. There's a time East Africa had an East African shilling, and the East African shilling was used across East Africa. I think that to minimize our dependence on any foreign currency, integration is the way to go. So the East African community, the COMESA, the ECOWAS, but again, we need to know that there has been attempts to create these regional currencies. So why did the East African shilling fail? Maybe you can link that to the politics of the time. But have these politics been resolved? Because we have, East Africa is one of the progressive regional integrations. I think across Africa, we are doing well in integration. But why haven't we integrated politically? Why haven't we integrated economically? I agree with you, Mr. Ojambo, that there is no need for me to buy things in Kenya and I have to buy them in US dollars. That doesn't make sense for us as Africans. I mean, I don't need to go to Kenya. If I'm going to Kenya, I don't need to go with US dollars, because that is what increases the dependence. That a Ugandan is going to Tanzania, he's looking for US dollars because US dollars are easily exchangeable in other countries. Now, then we need to regionally to have a currency that is exchangeable. I understand that within the SADC region, the South African rand is more exchanged, because I think Zimbabwe at some point had abandoned their dollar, the Zimbabwean dollar, and adopted the rand. So there has to be a dominant currency in the region that can be used and acceptable across the board. Which currency would that be? For East Africa, maybe we can say the Kenyan shilling. But there's also politics around that. There's politics around that. You may find that countries may resist that because they think that Kenya is going to dominate. But can we develop a regional currency that can dominate the regional economies?
interesting stuff there. And the whole question should be, if we can have all the transactions done in shillings, does it in any way help us aid the value of our currency, or are we just doing it for independence? And the question also would be, for all the guys that come in from these foreign countries, would they be okay to have only the local currencies used in the particular countries they visit, or they will still have to have these dollars move, have them exchanged? We'll wait to see how this will be happening. Actually, I saw on Twitter there was a whole conversation of, is what Tanzania is saying actually applicable? We'll wait and see. Some of these things can happen only if we are willing to allow them happen. Time now for a quick break on the program with me, Simon. Stay with us. I'll see you shortly. In the meantime, let's have the conversation on our social media handles right below your screen after the break.